Dear friends, this is Prithvi Raj from Bangalore connecting with you once again through this short message on Beatitudes. Beatitudes is the collection of the blessings proclaimed by Jesus Christ mentioned in Matthew 5th chapter verses 3 to 12. The word blessed in Beatitudes refers to the fortunate state as defined by Christ. The Beatitudes highlight the inner characters that Jesus expects in his followers. There are two sources of blessings, God and the world. The blessings from God are very much different from the blessings of the world. In the world, we are called blessed on the basis of the powers, the positions, and the possessions we have. But the Beatitudes talks about Godward blessings and not the worldward ones. The blessings from God are eternal. The significance of the Beatitude is the emphasis it has on the inward change required to attain the blessings offered by God through Christ. It highlights the efforts required from outside to receive the true blessings of God. Beatitudes list out Godward attitudes like spiritual poverty, mourning, purity, and spiritual hunger, and also the manward concerns like meekness, mercifulness, and peacemaking. It concludes with the needed long-suffering in the midst of persecutions. Poor in spirit means our spiritual depravity. It starts with recognizing our spiritual inability to live up to the expectations of God. It would mean understanding our spiritual need and resting on God to meet it. Godly sorrow refers to the realization about our inadequacy to meet the standard of God. In 2 Corinthians 7:10, we read that godly sorrow brings repentance that leads to salvation. Someone said, "Godly sorrow is a gift of the Spirit. It is a deep realization that our actions have offended our Father and our God. It is the sharp and keen awareness that our behavior caused the Savior to endure agony and suffering." Meekness would mean being soft-natured and not easily provoked. This refers to the willingness to take wrongs done to us patiently. Being meek doesn't mean weakness, but the gentle strength that exhibits goodness and kindness. Hunger and thirst for righteousness would refer to our spiritual appetite. It is the sign of our spiritual status and growth. Spiritual hunger will drive us to seek the ways and the will of God, leading us towards deeper spiritual life. Being merciful would mean forgiving all who did wrong to us, being sensitive to the needs of others, and making possible efforts to address those needs. God is merciful towards us, and this has to prompt us to be merciful towards others. Being pure in heart would refer to the purity in our inner life. It emphasizes the purity in our thoughts, imaginations, and desires. Being pure also would mean being reliable, honest, and faithful with respect to our relationship with others. Being a peacemaker would mean actively seeking to reconcile people to God and to one another. Peacemaking process is not easy, and it demands extra commitment and determination at times. When we get actively involved in peacemaking, we reflect an essential attribute of God in our daily life. being persecuted for righteousness is different from other beatitudes. We pursue all the other beatitudes, but this beatitude will pursue us when we commit ourselves to follow the footsteps of Christ. How do we react when we face persecution is what matters. Let us pray. Father, thank you for the teachings through the list of beatitudes. Help us to understand the real blessings and privileges we have in Christ. Enable us to make the right efforts to attain those invaluable blessings. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for listening. May God bless you.